لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام سيد الحبيب المرسلين محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، dear respected ulama, dear respected elders, brothers, sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. After praising the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending salutations on Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I begin by thanking UKIM for giving me this opportunity to convey the message of Allah and His Messenger Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I pray to the Almighty Allah that Allah gives me the ability in delivering this message. As I pray to the Almighty Allah, that Allah rewards you in listening to this message. Allah says in the Quran that every soul shall taste death. Allah does not care who you are, where you from. Allah does not care if you're strong. Allah does not care what city you're from. Allah does not care if you're even a prophet. Allah does not care that if you worship Allah for 100 years, Allah says every soul shall taste death. And everyone will leave this world. You have the greatest people that ever walked on the face of this planet. They were none other than the prophets of Allah. You have the likes of Sulaiman alayhi salam. As Abdullah says radiallahu anhu, that when Sulaiman alayhi salam, when he used to travel, he says he used to be sitting on a throne, and these thrones used to be surrounding him, and the humans and the jinns used to be sitting around him. Behind him, there used to be animals. Above him, there used to be birds that used to give him shade from the sunlight. The narration says that a tornado, a wind used to come and lift this whole army up and take them to a different land. In spite of the fact that Allah gave him this kingdom, Allah says every soul shall taste death and he departs from this world. You have the likes of Musa alayhi salam. Musa alayhi salam is that prophet of Allah, one of the greatest prophets of Allah. Allah gave him this stick, and with this stick, when he's to hold it in his hand, it's to be a stick, and when he's to drop it to the ground, this stick used to turn into a serpent. With this very stick, he points towards the ocean, and the ocean makes way, and Musa alayhi salam and his people make the crossing. In spite of the fact, Musa alayhi salam, being the prophet of Allah, the one who conversed with the Almighty Allah, Allah says every soul shall taste death, and he's departed from this world. You have the likes of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the prophet of Allah. Such is the status of this prophet that his name is written on the palaces of Jannah. His name is written on the eyes of angels. His name is written on the leaves of the Tuba tree. Such is the status of this prophet that Allah raises his mention. Allah says that his character is sublime. Allah says he's a mercy for mankind. In spite of him being the final messenger, the seal of all prophets, in spite of him being the imam of all the prophets before him, Allah says every soul shall taste death and he departs from this world. You have the great Imam al-Bukhari, and the great Imam al-Bukhari was that muhaddith that he had memorized 10 million hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And regarding Imam al-Bukhari, in spite of his super fast memory, in spite of his super quick tongue of his, Allah says every soul shall taste death and he departs from this world. You have the great Imam Ahmad, who had memorized 1 million hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who knew the biographies of every single narrator, He knew the fatawa of the Sahaba, the fatawa of the Tabi'een, and the fatawa of the Atba'u Tabi'een. But in spite of the fact that he was given the title, the Imam of the world, Allah says, every soul shall taste death and he departs from this world. And from the kuffar you have Nimrud. Nimrud was that person that Allah the Almighty brought him into existence. Allah the Almighty gave him everything. As Ibn Kathir writes, that four people have ever ruled the world, two being from the Muslims and two being from the kuffar. The ones from the Muslims, Sulaiman alayhi salam and Zulqarnain, and from the kuffar, Nimrud and Bukhti Nasr. And Nimrud, Allah ordered the winds to throw him into a jungle when he was a baby. And when he was thrown in the jungle, Allah ordered the trees to shade him. Yet again, the Almighty Allah blessed him so much that Allah, the Almighty, gave him such blessing that he ordered the jinns to teach him how to rule the world. And he became the ruler of the world. And you know how he repaid the Almighty Allah? Messenger comes to Nimrud and he says to Nimrud, believe in Allah. And he says, too right, I'm going to believe in Allah. You believe in me. I am your Lord Most High. In spite of the fact he being the ruler of the world, Allah says every soul shall taste death. Mosquitoes come. They eat half of his army. Allah sends a mosquito. This mosquito goes through his ear, lands on his brain and eats off his brain. He eats off his brain until Nimrud drops to his knees. Allah says every soul shall taste death and he drops. You have the likes of Fir'aun, the biggest zalim that ever walked on the face of this planet. He used to spare the women. He used to kill the newborns. In spite of him being the biggest zalim on the face of this earth, Allah says every soul shall taste death. The oceans open. Fir'aun boasting that I have done this for you. This is from me. They try making the crossing. Allah orders the ocean to close on him. Allah says every soul shall taste death. And down goes Fir'aun. You have the people of Ad. And who were these people? They were giants. You have big giants. And regarding these giants, the narration says that they were so strong. They were so strong that as Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu says, the amount of weight that they used to pick up, if 500 of us got together and tried moving an inch, we would not be able to do so. And regarding them, they used with their own hands, with their bare hands, they used to make their houses from mountains. In spite of their super size and super power, Allah says every soul shall taste death and they depart from this world. How? Allah sends tornadoes and he destroys them. You have the likes of Jibreel. And Jibreel alayhi salam, regarding him, he's got 60,000 wings. In spite of his 60,000 wings, in spite of him being the archangel, the main angel, he lifts a city up. He takes you up to the lowest heaven, so close that the narrations say that the angels heard the dogs barking and the chickens croaking. And Jibreel turned the city and he destroys them. In spite of his mighty power and mighty size and mighty role, Allah says everything will come to an end and they will come to an end. You have the angels who are carrying Allah's throne. And the ones who are carrying Allah's throne, the narration says that the distance between their feet and their knees is a distance of 500 years. And distance between the earlobe and the neck is a distance of 70 years. And in spite of the fact that they being the arch, the big angels who are carrying Allah's throne, that their feet are on the lowest earth and their shoulders are in the highest heaven. The distance between the first heaven is the distance of 500 years. The distance between the first and the second, 500 years. Second to the third, 500 years. Third to the fourth, 500 years. Fourth to the fifth, 500 years. Fifth to the sixth, 500 years. Sixth to the seventh, 500 years. Could you imagine how big these angels are? Yet again, Allah says, everything will come to an end, and they will come to an end. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you will die the way you live. If you lived a life of disobedience, if you lived a life of sin, then you will die the same way, and you will be resurrected the way you died. A police officer working in a Muslim country, he writes to a scholar and he says that my return to the Almighty Allah, his return to the Almighty Allah, he writes, one occasion we were on a highway and we were parked upon the hard shoulder, and all of a sudden everything's quiet. Me and my partner, we were talking. He says moments pass, and all of a sudden there was a big bang. The officer writes, and when we look behind us, what did we see? A head-on collision. There was a head-on collision. He says we went running towards the car, and we found two young lads. We took these two young lads out, and we put them on the side. We went running to help the other guy in the other car, but what did we find? That he was dead. And when we returned back to these two young lads, we asked the young lads, that who are you? Yet again there was no reply. My partner started instructing them, that say La ilaha illallah. Say La ilaha illallah. But there was no reply. Yet again my partner started instructing him, say La ilaha illallah. Yet again there was no reply. And when he repeated it again, he said, my partner instructed them to say La ilaha illallah. Yet again there was no reply. And at this moment, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you will die the way you live. If you lived a life of disobedience, if you lived a life of sin, you will die the same way. And when he was on the verge of dying, instead of uttering Kalima La ilaha illallah, he starts singing a satanic song. He starts singing a satanic song. He says, shocked by this, my partner starts instructing him again, say La ilaha illallah. Yet again, the same thing. Both young lads were singing a satanic song. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you will die the way you live. If you lived a life of disobedience, if you lived a life of sin, listening to music, then you'll die the same way, and you'll be resurrected the way you died.